Hello, everybody. I'm Ben Perry from Pangea Group, and I'd like to start off by saying if anybody in the future is an inductee and gets to the bottom of their list and looks at Robin Hunter's phone number, call me first. As a good consultant, I can help you out there. I have the distinct pleasure of introducing Paul Petrelli to you today. A little bit of a story just to start off, and this is a bit ad hoc, but when I first met Paul, I went into his office for a meeting, and he was wearing this camouflage outfit. And you may know Paul is quite stylish, and he often wears good suits and so forth. And so one of the first times I met him in person, he's wearing this camouflage outfit, and I'm thinking, okay, well, maybe I'm here for some basic training or something of the sort, because he's a man of good stature, and he works out, and he's athletic. And he's very direct and candid, as you all know, by his presentation this morning, which is one of the great things about Paul. But further to that, as I started interacting with his team, I also noticed that there were pictures of him all over the office. And it was a picture of him cuddling a cat. And, you know, I start going around, and I'm seeing this picture everywhere, and I start asking people, you know, why is there a picture of Paul with a cat all over the office in everyone's offices? And I didn't quite understand it then, but I understood it now as I spent more time with Paul and really understood, you know, the very direct and engaging way that he engages his teams and the people he works with. You know, having a span of experience working with GSK, AstraZeneca, Biogen, and now Jazz Pharmaceuticals. Paul's a man that when you talk to him, he's direct with you. He looks in your eyes, he listens to what you have to say, he takes that in. But he's also an amazing mentor and coach. And I did realize after working with his team and him through that that initiative that picture was a testament to their respect of how great a mentor Paul is and how well he runs an organization and builds a culture within his organization. We talked about culture this morning, and I think Paul is a great example of how to drive that, that within an organization. So that basic training actually turned out to be advanced training in many respects, and I'm grateful for that and the relationship that I have with Paul, and he's touched so many other organizations as well, working with McMaster, Rotman School of Business, and in other engagements where he's really added and given back to the community. Busy man, but he always is right there with you in the moment when you're working with him, and I'd just like to pass it over to Paul and give him credit to speak.
So for the record, I don't own a cat, and frankly, I don't like cats. There's a longer story behind it, and probably way too much time for us to take up here. I'm both honored and humbled by the recognition, and I want to thank the committee as well for this great nomination. When I look at the posters up against the wall and also the people in the room, I feel like I'm standing on the shoulders of giants. There's a lot of people in this room who have contributed to my development, my success, given me opportunities. Robin's one of them. I've never worked with him, but I just figure I got to mention your name. But on top of that, I've had the pleasure of working with a lot of people in here as well, and it's always been a great opportunity. There's one person here that isn't with us, is an inductee, it's Paul Lucas, who I credit a lot of my development to as well, because I think years ago when I first was a product manager, and he threw me an opportunity or a task to be able to look at the business rationale for a certain product, and I came in and I said, don't launch it. And he looked at me and said, come to my office, and I figured, okay, that's it. I'll probably be asked and offered up to the market for an opportunity as well, and I always thought Starbucks would be a good one. He said, look, think of it in my position. He goes, look at the organization and think through this a little bit further. Do you have any risk? And think beyond just your brand. And it was a big thing for me, so I took that away, and obviously I could read between the tea lines and say, okay, look, we're going to launch this. So I came back and I said, we're going to launch it anyways. But it was a key learning for me in terms of my leadership and development to be able to look at this and say, sometimes it's not exactly what's in your face. I think you have to look beyond and take in as much as you can to be able to make a decision. But again, I think to echo what Kevin's saying, I think this is a wonderful industry, although even this morning we talked a lot about some of the woes that we have around market access, patents, the payers, etc. I think it still is one that the reason what drives most of us and all of us in here and gives us our purpose is we know we make an impact. We make an impact on patients' lives every day. And as leaders, we make an impact on our employees and people every day. And I think that's the best gift that can be given to us every day from everyone else. So I personally think it's the best job in the world. So thank you.